Hello class 7, so today we will read the second chapter of CIVIC, that is Institutional Representative of Democracy. Open page number 186 of your book. I hope you have opened your book. Now we will read about learning outcomes. Learning outcomes means what we will learn in this chapter. So read this. By the end of this chapter, you will be able to develop the links between the ideal of democracy and the institutional form or the process associated with it. Explain the importance of each of the institutional representations of democracy, namely universal adult franchise, elections, political party and coalition of government. So you will learn about the democracy, that India is a democratic country, yes or no? So we are the Indians, and if you are 18 plus, then you are having a right to vote. You belong to any religion, any caste or any land, you are having the right to vote. So first of all, warm up exercise. The warm up chart is there, you will read the warm up. Okay, look at the picture given above. It shows a theme from the first Lok Sabha election of India held in January 1952. So the question is that when our first Lok Sabha election of India held, it is held on January 1952. The election officer on the right is checking the identity of the woman who came to vote. Why is it necessary to do this? So when we go for a vote, there is a voter ID card. When we go for a vote, we have to show that voter ID to the representative. So why that voter ID card is important? Once the voter enters the voting room, a mark will put on her finger with an invisible ink why it is done. You have seen that when your mother or father go to just vote, cast their vote. So there is a mark of ink on the finger, yes or no? So why they put that? Is there any difference between the Lok Sabha election were conducted in 1952 and the way they are conducted today? So there is any difference between that election or the election that is going in today's era? So some differences are there. In earlier time, the people used to vote on the ballot papers, but now EVM machines are there. So many changes are there. You can discuss that changes with your elder. Okay. Now we will start reading the chapter. We have learned about the values and the ideals of the democracy, liberty, equality, justice, diversity and sovereignty. How does a democracy hold these values? So India is a democratic country, and there is a justice for the people, for all the people. Equality is there, right to education is there. It does so through the certain institution and the process, such as the universal adult franchise, election, political parties, coalition government. In this chapter, you will look at some institution through which a democracy functions. So in this chapter, we will learn about the functions of democracy. Okay. Universal adult franchise. The Constitution of India grants the people of India universal adult franchises. This means that every Indian citizen above the age of 18 has right to vote. If you are 18 plus, then you are having a right to vote. Yes or no? Representative of caste, economic status and religion or a gender. Only those who are unsound mind means mentally ill, or you can say that mentally sick, and those have been convicted of criminal offense are not allowed to vote. If a person is having a criminal background, then that person is not allowed to vote. If the person is mentally sick or the person is having any criminal background, that person is not allowed to cast their vote. Okay? Two main points are that if you are 18 plus, then you are allowed to vote. And second point, if you are mentally ill or mentally sick, or you are having any criminal background, so you are not allowed to vote. Each citizen can cast only one vote, and the value of every vote is the same. So every vote counts. This is a quote. Every vote counts. So we get only one chance to vote. We cannot vote We can vote only one time to our representative, and every vote counts. Every vote means a lot. Every vote is important. Therefore, when the elections are there, before that, the political parties used to campaign, and the televisions, on the television, there are the advertisement that go and vote, go step out from your house and vote, and every vote just value a lot, every vote counts. So the every single vote is very important, okay? Each citizen can cast only one vote, and the value of every vote is the same. Thus, through the institution of the universal adult franchise, every citizen of India is equally empowered. It is in fact that cornerstone of Indian democracy. Cornerstone of Indian democracy means, cornerstone means that it is very important part of democracy, that every Indian citizen, if you are 18 above, you are having right to vote, and every vote counts. Every vote is important. Okay. The election. We learned in the last chapter that India is an indirect democracy. Okay. India is an indirect democracy. India follows this policy or form of government. We have learned in the previous chapter. This means that the Indian citizen choose a group of people to run the government on their behalf. We choose our representative, our rulers. Yes or no? The process of selecting representatives to run the government, the country, is called an election. So, when we choose our representative, that process is known as election. Election means what? When so many representatives are there from different parties, and we will choose our representative. No, according to me, this leader is perfect. It is having a good performer. So I will choose this leader. I think that he will do something better for our country or for our state or for our area. So we will choose the best representative according to our choice. So that is known as election. The India, two major kinds of election are held, the general election and the state assembly election. So you have to learn these two very well. The general elections for representative are elected to the Lok Sabha in the central government. So when we talk about the central government, so for the elections are held for the Lok Sabha. The elections are held for the Lok Sabha. Okay. And when the state elections are there, they are held for Rajya Sabha. Okay. The general election for representative are elected to the Lok Sabha in the central government. So general elections where the representative are elected to the Lok Sabha in the central government. General election mein the members and the representative are chosen for the Lok Sabha. And the state assembly election where representative are chosen for the state legislative assembly. If there is an election for the Prime Minister, okay, if the election is there for the Prime Minister, so that election is known as Lok Sabha election, that held within a 5 years. After 5 years, the elections are held. Okay, when you choose for example Prime Minister, so that is known as general elections. General election, and when we are choosing our CM, that is the state election. Yes or no? Because CM will work for the state and PM will work for the country. Okay, both the general elections and the state and assembly elections have been held once in a 5 year. Yes or no? After 5 years, the elections are held unless there is a state of emergency in the country like war. If the minister is dead or the war is there, so we can hold the election before 5 years. But if there is no issue like this, so election will be held after 5 years. Okay. Constitutionaries and reserve of constitutionaries. For the purpose of election, the country is divided into the number of small called constitutionaries are the created on the basis of population. such as each constituency has an equal number of people, each constituency elect and send one person to the government. There is one set of the constituencies of the Lok Sabha election and a separate set of constituencies for the state assembly election. Some constitutions are reserved for certain communities such as the scheduled caste, scheduled tribe and also Indians. Only people from those communities can contest from the poll that reserves seat. This has been done to make the legislative bodies as inclusive as possible by ensuring that the people from all group of society get representative. So first of all, read this paragraph, then I will explain this paragraph to you. I hope you have read that. So it means that certain number of the people, the fixed number of the people are there, and they can be the member of the Lok Sabha or Raj Sabha. Okay. You have seen the news, or you have seen in the news about the Lok Sabha or the Raj Sabha. You can see that many people are sitting over there. They are the members of the Lok Sabha or the Raj Sabha. So how they get there? So we are the one, those who choose our representative to represent our community in Lok Sabha or Raj Sabha. They are the members that are chosen by us. We choose these people who can represent our area in the Lok Sabha or the Raj Sabha. Some seats are fixed in Lok Sabha and Raj Sabha. Some of the seats are fixed in Lok Sabha and Raj Sabha. Okay, that seats are for the scheduled caste and scheduled tribes. Scheduled caste means SC and scheduled tribes means ST. So some seats are reserved for these people, and the members those who are there in the Lok Sabha and the Raj Sabha are the people those who are chosen by us. We are the one who choose those people who are sitting over there, and they are taking decision on behalf of us. Okay, so this is for today only. Today in next video, I will continue with the further chapter and I will explain more about this chapter. So till then, you have to read this chapter very well. The two pages that I taught you today, you have to read that and you have to learn the definition that I gave you. Okay, thank you and have a nice day.